Welcome back, students. Today let us start with a new chapter, and the name of the chapter is yield line analysis. This yield line analysis is unit 4 of your syllabus. So welcome to lecture 16 of design of concrete structures 1. The yield line theory is one of the most important developments in the analysis and design of slab systems. The yield line theory is the ultimate load theory for the design of RC slabs. In case of slabs, the computation of ultimate load is quite complicated. In the yield line method, the computation of ultimate load is based on the pattern of yield lines that are developed in the slabs under conditions approaching collapse. So when the slab is fully loaded with ultimate load, reinforcement and concrete can take the stresses up to load level corresponding to the yield stress in reinforcement. If the load is further increased, excessive deformations and rapid increase in strain will result. Now these deformations will be elastoplastic up to a load level called limit load. When limit load is reached, the slab will continue to deform without any additional load, leading to total collapse. Now at this stage, a pattern of cracks will form, a set of lines known as yield lines, resulting into mechanism leading to total collapse of the slab. So to define yield line is defined as a line in the plane of slab across which reinforcement bars have yielded and about which excessive deformation under constant limit movement continues to occur, leading to failure. Now there are many characteristic features of yield lines. First, yield lines are straight so that they may act as plastic hinges of the collapse mechanism. Yield lines terminate at the slab boundary or at the intersection of other yield lines. Yield line act as axis of rotation for the movement of adjoining segment. Each segment of the slab will tend to rotate in a rigid body motion. If an edge is fixed or continuous, a yield line may form along the support. Now these are some sign conventions which are used when it comes to yield line analysis. If it's a straight solid line, it indicates free or unsupported edge. The next one is for simply supported edge, fixed or continuous edge. Uneven line is for positive yield line. Dash line is negative yield line. Then axis of rotation, beam support and column. You need to keep these things in mind as we have to read any diagram or we have to read any case only on these sign conventions. Okay, so at least 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th are very, very important. Beam support and column, it is very common, so it is understood. Now yield line patterns. We are going to learn yield line patterns only for slabs. So in slabs, we have two types of slab. One is called as one-way slab and other one is called as a two-way slab. Now this one-way slab and two-way slab, the differentiation is based on the deflection of the slab, how the slab deflects. So in one-way slab, the deflection of the slab happens only in one direction, and in two-way slabs, the deflection of the slab happens in both the directions. See, in one-way slab, it's not that there is no deflection in the other direction, but it is very, very less as compared to deflection in one direction. So in one-way slab, we have one simply supported slab and one fixed slab. When it comes to two-way slabs, we have different geometrical diagrams or geometrical shapes wherein the slabs can be designed. So one is square, rectangular, triangular, circular and hexagonal. So we are going to basically learn yield line patterns for all these five types of two-way slabs and one-way slabs. So now in each, that is square slab, we have simply supported and fixed slab. In rectangular, we have simply supported, fixed, then two edges simply supported, two fixed, three edges simply supported and one free. So these are different cases for rectangular. There are many more. I have listed some important ones here. In triangular, there is a simply supported triangular slab, there is fixed edge triangular slab, two sides simply supported and one fixed, two sides simply supported and one free, and so on. So circular we have two, hexagonal we have two. So basically when we talk about slabs, as I said, it is a area wherein which is used for any purpose, maybe residential or commercial. Basically it is an open space where we can keep our things, or we can walk over, or we can utilize the area. Okay, so now this particular slab or any slab has three types of load on that on the slab. One is that live load, that is the load that is moving. Second one is the dead load, that is the furniture or the things which are kept on the floor and which will be constant, which will not move in and out again and again. And third one is the floor finish, that is the tiles or marble or kota, whatever we fit onto the slab. That also weighs a lot. So we have also considered the loads when we are designing any type of a slab. So for slab, there are three types of loads: one, dead load, live load, and floor finish. Okay. So now, once you cast a slab and the slab is loaded, as I already explained to you in the previous slide, the slab will start taking the load and slightly deform. When I say deform, it is deflection. Basically, it is bending moment. Okay, so it will deflect in certain way. To counter this deflection, what do? We provide tensile reinforcement. So with this reinforcement, the slab will stand intact in the position and serve the purpose of the slab. But due to the loading, as I said, there is deflection either in one way or there will be deflection in both the ways. Now, if the load is further increased, it will still deflect. It will deflect till the tensile reinforcement takes the load. Once you increase the load further, wherein the tensile reinforcement fails and also the concrete fails in taking care of the stresses that are developed, what will happen? The slab will get cracks, and also it may lead to a total collapse of the slab. So what happens is, in between when the load increases, the slight cracks may be seen or visible, but at the time of total collapse, it will just fall off. So the cracks are developed at one of the stage. This indicates that the load has reached its maximum point and it may collapse anytime. So that is the first step of collapse mechanism. Okay, failure mechanism basically. So you will first start seeing small cracks at the bottom of the slabs, or where there is tension in the slab. So basically, in yield line patterns, we are going to study the failure pattern of the slab, how the slab will fail, how it will look when it will fail. Yield line means the line where the slab is yielded. And there are different patterns according to the different type of slabs. Okay, it is very difficult to find out what is the ultimate movement in the design. Ultimate movement is the final movement at point where slab fails. Okay, it is very difficult to trace that movement because we cannot measure it in any of the units or any of the machines. So this is another way wherein we can find out what will be the moment or the ultimate moment for the failure of the slab or for collapse of the slab. And the total analysis is called as the yield line analysis or yield line pattern. So here in this, what we are going to learn is, we will see what is the yielding pattern of slabs which is already predefined or which are standard. Why these are predefined? Depending on the experience. It's already there, it is already studied, and we know that this particular slab is going to fail in this particular pattern. Now, depending on this yield line pattern, we will see what will be the maximum moment or the failure moment for that slab. Okay. So when it comes to one-way slab, as I explained to you, one way is when it is deflected in only one direction. So if there are two supports for the slab and there is load W, then the deflection will happen in shorter direction, and the maximum moment at the center will be WL square by 8. Now, where the point where the bending moment is maximum, the yield line will start appearing there. Yield line means the cracks on the slab will start appearing there. So there is a diagram with a yellow box I've shown here, wherein the yield line is shown at the center as maximum bending moment is at the center. So the one-way slab will always crack or will start failing at the center first, and then the lines will develop at different points. Okay. So it will start with this yield line, and after that a small yield line will be generated here and here also, and it will go on, but it will start from this point as it is the weakest point, as it is the weakest point in the slab. Okay, so similarly, if you go for a fixed slab, now the previous one which we saw was a simply supported slab. See this, it gives you as a simply supported edge. This particular sign convention is used to identify a simply supported slab. So in the next one we will see a fixed slab. Okay, so from here we can make out that it is a fixed slab in both the direction. So in this figure, the bending moment, negative bending moment, will be at the edges. Due to this fixity, there will be a negative bending moment of minus WL square by 12, and at mid-span there will be positive bending moment of WL square by 24. You have already learned this, why that it is WL square by 24 and all. Okay, so I will not go into this, but now due to this bending moment at the ends, there will be a yield line developed at the support, and due to this mid-span positive moment, there will be a yield line that will develop at the center. Okay, so this small dash line, you can see it is the negative yield line and this is positive yield line. Now this negative and positive depends on the negative moment and the positive moment that are developed in the slab. Because here there is positive moment, the yield line here is called as a positive yield line. This is due to the negative bending moment, so the yield line at the support is called as a negative yield line. And as I said, the sign convention, if the yield line is like this, it is a positive yield line, and if yield line is dashed at the support, it means it is a negative yield line. Okay, so this is for a one-way slab. What is a working? So basically, why these cracks get developed, I have explained to you again. I will just go through it again. At service loads, service loads is the total load which are expected to come on the slab, which I discussed as dead load, live load and floor finish. The slab will be uncracked, but as the load is increased, cracks will be developed at the top of slab in negative moment region and at the bottom in the positive moment region. As the load is further increased, the negative and positive steel will start yielding. At the yield load, the entire width of the slab will develop cracks and yield lines will be formed. Now for simply supported slab, such a yield line will be formed at mid-span, as that is the weakest point. And for fixed support, negative yield lines will be formed at the supports and positive line yield line will be formed at the mid-span. We just discussed it in the previous slab. Now the main note, the terms positive yield line and negative yield line, as I discussed, are used to distinguish between those associated with tension at the bottom and tension at the top of the slab respectively. Now in one-way slab, the direction of the yield line is perpendicular to the direction of the steel. This is always. Okay, so here in this diagram, if you see, okay, we are going to provide the steel bars in this direction. The steel bars will be in this direction. So the yield line is exactly perpendicular to the reinforcement that is provided in one-way slab. In two-way slabs, here is a typical yield line pattern for two-way slab, square slab. So this is simply supported. There will be cracks as diagonals. Here this is a fixed square slab, so the positive yield lines will remain the same and the negative yield lines will be formed, which is extra yield line towards the support. Okay, so if you want to see the initiation of this, it will be something like this. So if it is a square slab, it will start at the center as this is the weakest point, then it will develop in all four directions. Okay, so this is the initiation, development and growth. These are some of the diagrams, typical yield line patterns for different geometrical figure shapes.